Hello. Greetings. This is going to be a Gorian topic. Lately, in one of the Gorian forums I am on, we had a poster asked, could Domina, I use the term either female dominant or Domina, be a part of the Gorian lifestyle? And the reason why I bring it up here is that this is a question that pops up among Gorians every now and then. And of course, quite a few on the thread said, oh no no, all women within the Gorian lifestyle are submissive, yada 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 yada. But I don't agree. Here's the point. Could you? Yes, you could. And one of the tenets of the Gorian lifestyle is that the sorts of others set your limit. So unless somebody who really want to try to force you not to live out this, you can. And as a free woman, and a female dominant would then most likely be a free woman, the only person that has any right to dictate what you do with your life is your free companion. Here's the point. Being a dominant within BDSM and being a Gorian are two different things. It's like, I am a Gorian free woman. I am also an occultist. I am also a goth. These things doesn't have anything to do with one another. The same way you can be a dominant and you can be a Gorian. Now, quite a few people, including some people who are Gorians, have this idea that the Gorian lifestyle is just a subset of BDSM. It isn't. Basically, here's the difference. BDSM is about that interaction. Now, it's an umbrella term, so it could be anything from tying your boyfriend up with the fluffy cord when you have your little tumble in bed. Or it could be somebody living 24/7 as a puppy girl or anything else. But the BDSM is about the interaction. Now, is it only about sex? No, of course not. For some people it is, but for many people it is about a lot more than sex. But even those that have BDSM as a lifestyle, it's about the interaction. The Gorian lifestyle is about the philosophy, about developing yourself as a human being and living with honor and integrity. The slavery aspect is just a tiny, tiny little part of it. So, yes. Now, there are several ways a free woman could be dominant. First of all, she could have slaves of her own. She could have, there are a few, not many, but there are a few male Gorian slaves. She can own one of those. She could own female slaves, and so on and so forth. And there's nothing wrong with that. And for those that like to book them, in the books there are several examples of Gorian free women who own slaves. And there's even mentioned that there is a market for male pleasure slaves. So, yeah. Other things that she could do is that she could bring it completely out of the Gorian lifestyle whatsoever. She could be a BDSM practitioner in addition to being a Gorian and have a relationship with somebody as Domina, as a mistress, whatever, within the BDSM community, and not even mix that with her Gorian life. And all of this is quite acceptable. I mean, even in the books, even for slaves, it's mentioned that quite a few free men enjoy playing spanky butt and order their slaves to do that for them. Basically swing the whip. And the point is this, dominant means a lot of different things within the BDSM community. It can, I mean, some person on the thread said, no, dominant is one of those that I get asked everybody what to do. But it depends on the person. You can be a dominant and just like to be on top in bed, or it can be a lifestyle or anything in between. And there's nothing within the Gregorian philosophy prevents this. Now, of course, discussing this, we did have some book thumpers on the thread that filled page up and page down with quotes with, oh, but all females need to be submissive to all men, and so on and so forth. That's a different topic, really. I have already in a few videos expressed my views on that as it being bullshit. Free woman is free and chooses who she wants to defer to. It's not like you have a penis, I have not, so I am going to defer to you in all things. And within the books themselves, there are a lot of examples of, like I said, I don't know, it never happens in the books that a woman make decisions for a man. I actually does. There are, among other things, a female slaver who runs a whole group of gang of slavers. You have women who have guards that she tells what to do. This, yes, within the Gregorian lifestyle, women are submissive to men, but that doesn't mean that a free woman is submissive to all men. But like I said, that's a different topic. And when it comes to a female dominant within the Gregorian lifestyle, it is going to be rare. And I don't think that there is anything within the philosophy that prevents her from doing this. However, it is a lifestyle that is more likely to attract females who are very submissive and males who are dominant, and not the other way around. And yes, one important thing within the books, in the Gregorian books, the world is necessarily reduced. It's books, it's fiction, it's fantasy. And as such, all women in the Gore books are at core submissive. And all men are at core dominant. That's just how it is. However, in the real world, it doesn't work quite like that. I agree that more women than men are submissive, and more men than women are dominant. However, one of the most important things within the Gregorian philosophy is to follow your own true nature, to be yourself. And as I have argued with a lot of Gregorians, that also includes when yourself is outside of the norm. So if you as a woman is naturally dominant, that is what you should be. Even when you are a Gregorian, you should be then dominant because that's part of your nature. Where you have a problem is when women are taking on male roles just because society tells it. The Gregorian lifestyle is about the freedom to be yourself. And I feel that it's just as important to be yourself when yourself doesn't follow the standard gender norms. Because I don't think there's anything that can be said about all members of a gender. So there will be submissive males who wants to be slaves, and there will be dominant women who wants to be dominant. And there's nothing wrong with that. However, I know exactly one dominant who are within the Gregorian lifestyle, and she has that pretty thick skin. I mean, even me, I'm definitely not a dominant, but I do have opinions that differ from a lot of the book-thumping Guardians. And I too do need a quite a thick skin on that, because... like I've said in a video before, there's a lot of people who come to the Guardian lifestyle with fantasies flowing out of their ears, who basically have no interest to sit down and meditate on the philosophies, trying to discover what the philosophies is. They just, oh, here's a quote, but here's the point. There are 32, is it now, books in the series. You can find a quote on about anything, and there are also a lot of things that are clearly part of the fiction, not part of the philosophy. So, yeah. But, now, I see this video is going a bit all over the place, but let me address another similar concept. Some people also ask, is Guardian Free Women dominant? No. It's not like you have dominant and submissive and the free women are dominant. No, most, 99% of all free women are submissive. It's just that one is then free. If you're gonna see about the role of a free woman within the Guardian lives, so look at, for example, wives in Viking society or wives in Spartan society. Submissive to their men, to their husband and to the men they respect, but still free and responsible for their own actions. That's a free woman. Could you say that the slaves are more submissive? Yeah, probably. However, most women within the Guardian lifestyle are submissive since it is a patriarchal lifestyle. However, I think that within this lifestyle, there is definitely room for those that are different. There is room for women who want to be dominant, who wants to own slaves, whatever within the lifestyle itself, and own a Kachira, or a Kachira for that matter, if that's her cup of tea, or she wants to be a BDSM dominant. In addition to being a Guardian, there are room for that. There's nothing in the philosophy that says you can't. And here's a very important thing. Just taking a quote here and there out of context, that doesn't constitute the philosophy. I mean, there are lots of quotes on how you are lowest of the low of when it comes to slaves. If you wear earrings, I know a lot of Guardian free women who wear earrings, because that's part of the culture on this fictional planet. It's not part of the philosophy. The philosophy doesn't say, no, you're a slave if you have earrings. One of the more difficult things when it comes to being a real world Guardian is to take the fiction, the Tarns, the spaceship and the giant talking bugs and put that in one context and get the philosophy out of it. Like I've used this comparison before with those that have made a lifestyle and a religion out of Star Wars. They don't think they run around with a laser sword that they can cut things to pieces with, because that's not part of the philosophy. But I look at, for example, the way the Jedi work, and that is basically a mix between several Eastern belief systems, which are then mixed together with a bit of creativity to just glue it all up. And basically, I know people who have taken that and said, oh, this is exactly what I want. I want this mix of various Eastern belief systems. And so they follow that, but that doesn't mean they will follow the culture of the Jedis or on Coruscant or whatever else fictional place. And you have the same thing within the Gorian lifestyle. I know exactly one free woman who covers up, who basically wears a face veil, because it's not part of the philosophy, it's part of the culture. And the same way when you just quote Trump, you don't really achieve anything, you don't really get the philosophy, because the philosophy is hidden in the fiction, it isn't the fiction itself. And as such, it doesn't really matter if character A at some point has said all women are submissive and all women should submit to all men, because the philosophy presented in the books at large tell otherwise. As such, there is nothing wrong with a free woman who has those sexual preferences to swing the whip on a man if he wants to. Now, it is very, very, very unlikely that a free woman is going to basically be having a 24/7 DS relationship with her male free companion. No, I don't really think that will happen, because it sort of goes against everything it is to be a free man. However, there's nothing wrong with her finding somebody else to have such a relationship with. Now, is it Gorian to be a free woman and a Domina? No, it isn't. It isn't a particularly Gorian thing to do, but none of us do only Gorian things. But she can be a Gorian, she can live by the philosophy and do it. So there's nothing wrong with having, of being a Domina and being a Gorian free woman. You can do that. You can even be a slave for that matter and be a Domina if your master allows you. But it's not going to be particularly common in this lifestyle, because it is a very big difference between what is against the philosophy and what just isn't a part of it, it doesn't touch into it whatsoever, and whatever other interests a Gorian free woman has besides court, it doesn't matter as long as it allows her to live a life where she tries to be her best, where she tries to live with honor and integrity, and where she tries to follow her true nature. If she do those things, she can live as a Gorian, and she can definitely do these things as a Domina. Though she would, of course, have. You won't find a female supremacist among Gorians, because really, the Gorian lifestyle is about the concept that there is a natural order. However, not everybody fit in that natural order. And that's my opinion on it. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Have a great day. Blessed be.